Hi, before this video, you should already understand the words and concepts found in financial statements. So these financial statements are the balance sheet and the income statement. Alright, so welcome back again to MBAbullshitDotCom. The topic for this video is ROE, return on equity, which is one of the profitability ratios of financial ratio analysis. So remember, you can always go back to MBAbullshit.com. Okay, so this video discusses and analyzes the ROE, which is one of my free videos in liquidity, on the liquidity ratios, profitability ratios, and market value ratios, which include these ratios over here. Alright. And after these, you can check out my next videos on MBAbullshit.com, such as my video on financial leverage ratios, which includes these ratios over here, and my other video on MBAbullshit.com about turnover ratios, which includes all of these ratios over here, down here. Okay, so let's get down to it. Let's start with a story. Let's say that ABC Company has $1,000 in net income per year and $3,000 in equity. What is the return on equity, or ROE? Very simple. The ROE is $1,000 divided by $3,000. Where do we get this $1,000? $1,000 in net income per year, based on the most recent year's earnings, or last year's earnings. Where do we get the $3,000? It's the $3,000 in equity. So we divide the numerator by the denominator and we get an ROE of 0.33, or 33%. So what does this mean? Well, this simply means that for every $100 the company owners have in equity, okay, it makes $33 in profit. Okay, the company makes $33 in profit for every $100 that the company owners have in equity. Therefore, a higher ROE is considered better. Okay, a higher ROE indicates that the company is more efficient in giving more profit to the company's owners compared to these owners' investment. Personal investment in the company. Now, a lower ROE indicates that the company is less efficient in giving more profit to the company's owners compared to their investment into the company, of their personal money into the company. Okay, now there are still some important flaws in using this ratio. Some things which make it not perfect, or some will even say make it wrong to use it. First of all, a high ROE does not necessarily mean a high cash flow. Why? Because the ROE formula uses profit instead of cash flow. Remember, financial managers prefer cash flow instead of profit. Okay? Your company might have a high ROE because of high accrued sales, meaning sales, you know, you make a sale but then your customer hasn't paid you yet. That's an accrued sale. And that will increase your profit without increasing your cash flow. Okay, so your company might have a high ROE because of high accrued sales and not cash sales, or the cash from these sales might be paid to the company too far into the future, okay, or very far into the future. All right, so it's important to note that. Secondly, conversely, a low ROE may be the result of high asset value from previous years' intense profitability, and maybe you're just taking a breather for this year or last year. Remember, in computing the ROE, you use the most recent year's earnings. So maybe you were just taking a breather last year, but then your company continues to grow fast with big profits. Okay, so that might. And thirdly, equity is based on on the assets equity. Okay, equity is based on what? How do you compute equity? Assets minus liabilities. Okay, how do you value the assets in that case? It's based on book value and not real market value. So, for example, one part of the assets of your company is a building or a car. Maybe if you try to sell that building or a car, you might be able to sell it for $1 million. But your accountant wrongly values it at $2 million because it was bought at $3 million, and after subtracting depreciation, they decided the book value is $2 million. But in the real world, you could only sell it for $1 million. So in that case, the market value is different from the book. The real market value is different from the book value, which is, in a way, is wrong compared to the market value, because it is not based on the real value that you can sell the asset. Instead, it's just based on some accounting rules. Okay? So it's important to note that. Okay. And fourthly, very important, is that the owner's actual investment. Remember, I said earlier that a high ROE means that you're earning a lot of profit, the owner is earning a lot of profit compared to his personal investment in the company, which is based on equity. But in reality, the owner's actual investment may be based on stock value, not simply based on equity. Now, this not simply based on assets minus liabilities. What is assets minus liabilities? This means equity, right? So how do you measure how much is the personal investment of an owner into a company? Is it based on equity? Well, accountants or the balance sheet will measure an owner's personal investment into the company by looking at the value of the equity. But in reality, the owners of the company or the owners of the shares of the company did not invest this amount into the company. How much did they invest into the company? Well, it depends on what price they bought the stock in the stock market, and that is the stock value. So unfortunately, when we compute ROE, we use equity, the value of equity, instead of a more real investment value, which is stock value, which in some sense would be better. So that's a flaw, this shows where this ROE is weak. Okay, the owner's actual investment might really be based on stock value, but the ROE does not take into account stock value and instead takes into account equity. Okay? All right, which is more of a balance sheet figure rather than the real investment of the owner. Okay. Now let's now analyze the ROE from a traditional standpoint. Okay, first of all, you would compare the ROE of a company to the historical ROE. Okay, so the ROE is higher now than in previous years, then it indicates that the company this year is better at creating profits for its owners compared to their personal investment. But like I said, the flaw here is that this personal investment is valued using the value of equity instead of stock value, which is probably more correct, or could be more correct. But anyway, traditionally, a higher ROE now means that the company is better at creating profits for its owners compared to their personal investment this year. If the ROE is lower now than last year's, then this indicates that the company this year is not as good at creating profit for its owners compared to their personal investment. Traditional analysis number two is to compare the ROE of this company to the ROE of other similar companies in the same industry or in similar industries. So if the ROE is higher than theirs, than these other companies, then it indicates that this company has a better ability to give profit to owners compared to owners' investments. Okay? Or that this company is better than other companies, that is better than other similar companies in giving profit to owners compared to the owners' investments. In other words, this company is giving a better deal than other companies. Not a better deal to customers, okay? It's giving a better deal to the owners of the company, because the owners get back a much larger profit compared to their own investment into the company, okay? Unlike with other companies, which might give less profit compared to owners' investments in those companies. All right. If the ROE of this company is lower than theirs, then when I say theirs, I mean other similar company, then this indicates better ability of your company, or no, not better ability, not lousier ability, worse ability, sorry. This indicates worse ability of your company to give profit to owners compared to owners' investments, compared to the other companies, the other similar companies. All right, so this company is giving a worse deal than other companies, a worse deal to owners compared to other companies which are giving a better deal to their owners. Okay, now I'd like to include some important tips when using this ratio. First tip to remember, now this isn't necessarily a tip on what to do, it's a tip on what to think about when you're using this ratio. Take note that to increase ROE, return on equity, a financial manager can simply manipulate, okay, can manipulate the books to get a higher ROE. How? By simply reducing equity of the company. How can he reduce equity? By increasing the proportion of debt. Because remember, equity is equal to assets minus liabilities. If the financial manager increases the liabilities, you will have a smaller amount of equity. And if you have a smaller amount of equity, then the profits of the company will look big compared to the small equity. And when the profits of the company look big compared to the small equity, you will end up with a higher ROE. See, so a higher ROE, again, is not necessarily good. It could be because the financial manager is manipulating things around to make the ROE look bigger. Okay. Now, you might say, what's wrong with that? What's wrong with increasing the liabilities to get bigger ROE? Well, nothing is wrong, but it's just something to think about. Because increased debt will increase interest expense and may therefore reduce profit. And when you reduce profit, you also reduce your ROE in the longer term, in the long run. You'll have a lower ROE, or you might end up with a lower ROE. The second tip I'd like to share is that increasing ROE by increasing debt also increases the risk of the company, because higher debt also means higher risk. Now, if you'd like to go deeper into this concept that higher debt means higher risk, I suggest you look at my other videos on MBA Bullshit, on CAPM, or the cost of equity, and another video on MBAbullshit.com about levered versus unlevered beta. But for now, simply believe me when I tell you that increasing debt also increases the risk of the company. Okay, and the increase in ROE may not be worth the increase in this risk. Okay, so there, I hope you learned something. Remember to share it if you like it. Follow me on Twitter. Look for MBA Bullshit, or join my fan page on Facebook for the latest updates on my latest videos coming out. I usually say it on Facebook or whenever I have a new video, that very useful video. So just go to facebook.com/MBAbullshit and forward my YouTube links on your email or on your other social media. So have a great day and goodbye.